Okay, now we know what Ansible is and we've just installed it. So what should be our first step here? What do you think? Okay, every answer that was different from backups was wrong. And don't even try to argue with me. We need to set up backups as soon as we can, so we don't lose our work and thus our time. Time is the only thing in this world that you can't replenish in any way. Once it's gone, it's gone. And it doesn't matter if you're a 15-year-old student with no money or Steve Jobs at his best. We need to protect our time. So let's do it. As a demonstration, I'll just backup my whole home directory and store it somewhere safe. You will learn the key concepts in this tutorial, and I think you will be able to modify it to your own purposes. So before we start, we need a safe place or destination to which we will backup our data. And this for sure isn't just another folder on the same disk drive. We need an external USB drive or thumb drive or some kind of network storage. I personally backup all of my devices to my NAS or network attached storage. For this, I'm using this non-enterprise grade DS218 by Synology. It houses only two disk drives, but that's plenty enough for my use case. I've got two separate physical drives in there. In RAID 1. RAID 1 means that all the data are mirrored between those two physical drives. So in case one of the drives fails, I won't lose my data. They are replicated on the fly between both of those drives. And I can continue my work without any interruption. I just need to replace that failed drive better sooner than later. So, what we need to do here is to mount our backup drive to our computer or server. If you don't know how to do that, look in the upper right corner for a link to a video about that. Or open the description of this video. Links to how to mount a USB or network drives will be there for you. Go through that and come back. I'll be here. I'm not going anywhere. Okay, now you have a relatively safe place where to put your backups. So how do you do the backing up itself using Ansible? We'll start slow. I will only backup my home folder on this local machine to an attached drive. Very simple. We'll do more complex stuff in later videos. Let's head to the terminal.
I'm here in my home directory. Let's create a directory where I'll keep all the things related to Ansible. Make dir ansible cd ansible. Now we won't dive deep right away. Instead, we will do this the easiest way we can. Let's create a directory in which we will keep our playbooks. Make dir-p /home/ansible/playbooks and create the first backup playbook. Let's create a file, say vim/playbooks/backup_home.yml. YML is the language or file type and extension that Ansible uses for its definitions. Start to create our first play. A definition of task we want Ansible to do. Start with three dashes. They signal the start of a document. After that, let's name our first play. Let's say backup home directory. Now we need to tell Ansible where to execute this playbook. Hosts, localhost. As we want to backup the home directory of this particular computer. Later, we will learn that we can specify here large groups of computers. Now, we will think one step ahead. During the creation of backup file, we will need, or better say, we would like to add time and date into backup file name. So we will create a variable where we will store this information. Vars. That's just short for variables. And we will add here one variable named date. Date colon lookup pipe date. You don't need to remember right now how this works exactly. For now, just remember that this will simply create text string with actual date and time. Don't worry, I'll give you a link in the description of this video from which you will be able to copy the complete contents of this file. And now the actual backup task for Ansible. Tasks, name, create archive of home directory, community general archive. This is community created type of task used for archiving. We will need to install this community general collection. I'm just doing a mental note here. Path, this is the directory we want to backup. I'll put in /home/py. You put here whatever your home directory is. Dest means destination. Where do we want to save the backup file? The path must be complete, including backup file name. Note the quotation marks here. Let's say /mnt/nas/backup/ pi for backups, / home, date, tar, gunzip. Believe it or not, that's all you need to do. Save the file and close it. Now, before we actually launch it, to be on the safe side, just make sure to run these two commands. Pip install packaging. This is a Python dependency which Ansible needs to work, and Ansible Galaxy collection install community general. This will install a collection of tasks, one of which we are using in our playbook. We will build on this knowledge later, but for now this will be sufficient. Okay, standing in the Ansible directory, you can just run your newly created playbook like this. ansible-playbook.backup_home.yml. Let's watch the magic happening. Play called backup home directory task gathering facts about our computer. Okay, task create tar archive for a home directory. Changed. This means that it actually did something. Play recap. Two tasks went okay and nothing failed. Great. Let's check the destination folder. I look at it through my main computer. Add n backups, pi for backups. Here you can see the backup files created every time I ran this playbook. It has today's timestamp and it's around 200 megabytes in size. The key thing here is that you can see that our Ansible playbook works.
Hope this video helped you. If so, please hit that like and subscribe buttons. It means a lot to me. Thank you. So that's it. This is our first small step in using Ansible. Next time, I'll take you a little deeper. Right now, we've just tipped our toe in the Ansible waters, but we need to learn to walk before we can run. See you in the next video, where I will teach you how to install things via Ansible. Bye!